Hello, I'm your host, Stewart Farnaby, and I'm happy to welcome you to another fun and always exciting kid show!
What has two humps and is found in the North Pole? A camel that's lost.
Check out what's on today's kid show.
Dizzy!
Special guest, Dizzy the Clown. Well, Merry Christmas, Dizzy. Stan the Pan Man plays the sleigh bells.
Instead of sleigh bells, I'm going to tip it to the side.
And on this farm he had
a story from Mrs. Fox.
We're just going to burn the food. Ooh. And we're going to see
a science experiment from Maynard and Mrs. V. And lots of fun on the kids' show. Okay, here's a joke for you. Why did the man pour ground beef on his head? Why, he wanted a meteor shower. Hey, what do you think of my new hat? I kind of look like Santa Claus, don't I? Oh, ho, ho.
Dizzy bells, dizzy bells, dizzy all the way. Oh, what fun it is to be dizzy all the way.
Well, Merry Christmas, Dizzy. Hey, wasn't that supposed to be jingle bells?
Jingle bells? I never heard of that one. That might be a hit someday, though. But Merry Christmas, and guess what, Stuart?
Oh, what?
I got a Christmas present for you.
For me?
Yes, for you.
Wow, that is so nice of you. Thank you. Shall I open it?
Well, yeah. I am so excited for you to see what it is.
Okay. Let's see here. Ah. Whoa. Ah. Thank you, Dizzy. Wow, I don't think anyone has ever given me pickles before.
Oh, I love pickles. I love sweet pickles, dill pickles, butter pickles, little round pickles, little long pickles. I really like spicy pickles, too. Hey, maybe that's why my hair's so green. I eat lots of pickles.
All right. Well, hey, Dizzy, I happen to have a Christmas present for you, too.
You have a present for me? Oh, goody, 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 goody. Wow! Thank you, Stuart. That was so nice.
Go ahead and open it.
I gotta try to guess what it is first. Just a second.
Okay.
I guess I'll have to open it. Whoa. Oh, this is so exciting. Oh, this is gonna be so fun. Socks! I needed some socks really bad. That is so nice of you. Thank you, Stuart. You see, look, my socks have holes in them. In fact, they're a little stinky too. How did you know I needed some socks?
Well, actually, your mama clown told me.
Oh, mama clown told you? Oh, Stuart.
What's wrong?
I'm sorry to get so emotional, but that was so nice of you. Mr. Cameraman, could you please give me a Kleenex? Oh, just a minute, Stuart.
Well, that's what you do. Take your time.
I don't always get emotional like this. All right, just a second. Okay, I'm better now. Oh, you know what, Stuart? I really can't stay because I gotta go practice my Christmas carols.
All right.
Dizzy bells, dizzy bells, dizzy all the way.
Well, Merry Christmas, Dizzy.
Oh, what fun it is to be dizzy all the way.
Well, you know, remember kids, it's always better to give than receive and to always say thank you whenever you get a present. Even if it's pickles. It's game time. Guess what the picture is before time runs out. figured it out yet? Oh, I'm sure you've seen this before. It's a peacock. Now, here's PB and AJ.
What is red and goes up and down? A tomato in an elevator.
Kids, Stan the Pan Man here again to show you another new instrument. Now this thing, I have a feeling you guys already know what this is all about. What do you think these things are called? I bet you guessed already. These things are called sleigh bells. Everyone say sleigh bells.
Sleigh bells.
Sleigh bells. So with sleigh bells, it's comprised of lots and lots of little individual jingle bells. You guys like singing that song? Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey! Pretty cool, right? So what you need, you can actually make one of these things yourself. During the holiday season, or in fact, you can probably find it in craft shops even right now. You can find buckets of these little jingle bells, and you can attach them onto a stick, or you can put a string through each of the bells and tie them together, and you can have like this little cluster of sounds, or you can put it onto a stick, and then all you have to do is just shake it. It's very fun, it has a very cool sound. And now that we know what this sound is all about, there's a couple different ways that I like to play these jingle bells. First of all, we have a handle, so if we want to, all we have to do, shake it real loud! Ah! But if I want to have more of a precise sound, then I want to have kind of like a rhythmic element. What I'm going to do, I'm going to take this set of sleigh bells, I'm going to tip it to the side and I'm going to shake it like this. And it's kind of like one of those things that we were doing with the egg shaker a while ago. You can shake, 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 shake. We can kind of like move our wrists back and forth. So you can create this cool sound. Fun with sleigh bells. It's even more fun when you add in a second set of sleigh bells.
Hey, thanks, Dan. Boy, I love sleigh bells. They remind me of the holidays. Well, next, we have a special story from Mrs. Fox at the Oskaloosa Public Library. It's all yours, Mrs. Fox.
Today, I'm going to do a very familiar song story that's been around for hundreds of years. If you know the story, sing it right along with me. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had a horse, E-I-E-I-O. With a neigh, neigh here and a neigh, neigh there. Here, neigh, there, neigh, everywhere, neigh, neigh. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had a cow, E-I-E-I-O. With a moo moo here and a moo moo there. Here a moo, there a moo, everywhere a moo moo. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had a pig, E-I-E-I-O. With a oink oink here and a oink oink there. Here an oink, there an oink, everywhere an oink oink. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had a hen, E-I-E-I-O. With a cluck cluck here and a cluck cluck there. Here cluck, there cluck, everywhere cluck cluck. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had a duck, E-I-E-I-O. With a quack quack here and a quack quack there. Here a quack, there a quack, everywhere a quack quack. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had a dog, E-I-E-I-O. With a bow wow here and a bow wow there. Here a bow, there a dot wow, everywhere a bow wow. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
Thank you, Mrs. Fox. Boy, that was wonderful. Okay, my friends, have you ever roasted a marshmallow on a campfire? Or how about roasting a chestnut on an open fire? Well, next Maynard and Miss V are going to roast both a marshmallow and a nut. To the science lab!
So, you're back with Mrs. V and...
Maynard the Lion! Hey, everybody!
And we have another really neat science experiment today, Maynard.
Oh boy, Mrs. V, I can't wait. What are we doing?
Well, do you know what a calorie is? Have you ever heard of the term calorie?
Calorie?
Yeah, calorie.
Aren't those in food?
Yes, those are in foods. And that's the amount of energy that you get from the food that you eat.
Oh, okay.
And some foods have more calories than other foods. And do you know how they figure out how many calories are in food?
No, I don't.
Well, they actually burn the food.
Burn the food? That sounds like it wouldn't taste very good.
Well, they don't eat it after they burn it, Maynard.
Oh, okay.
We're just going to burn the food.
Oh.
And we're going to see how the temperature changes in the water that I have above the food. Now, do you notice here, Maynard, I have a miniature marshmallow.
Oh, yeah,
and
yep.
I have a peanut.
Ooh, I like both of those.
Well, which one do you think, Maynard, has more energy in it?
I say the peanut.
I think we're gonna find out that you're right.
Oh, okay, well, let's do it.
We're going to do it. So right now, we've got the temperature of the water, and the temperature of the water, it looks like it's 22.2 degrees Celsius. Oops, it's changing a little bit. I guess the water and the air is a little bit different, but it's about 22.7 now. So that's Celsius. So let's light the marshmallow.
Yes,
I'm gonna burn it.
Oh, wow.
I have to burn it to figure out how many calories there are.
Okay.
Now, be safe, kids. That's right. Kids shouldn't do this themselves. They should probably have a parent working with them. Okay, so do you see we've got the marshmallow burning?
That's cool.
Yeah. And it's giving off energy. And we will see what it's doing to the temperature of the water. Okay, it's 30, 33.7, 35.4. Looks like the marshmallow went out And it was 35.4, I think, was the highest temperature it reached.
What does that mean?
That means that it produced enough energy that it changed the temperature of the water.
Oh.
Now, let's see what happens when we do the peanut.
Okay.
I think that it will probably change the temperature of the water more. We'll find out here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's find out. Okay, there we go. Now we have the peanut burning. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And we'll see what's happening to the temperature of the peanut here, of the water that's above the peanut. See, the peanut's still burning. What happens when you start seeing bubbles? What's the water starting to do?
It's starting to boil.
That's right. And look now, look at the flame that we're getting from the peanut.
Wow, look at that.
Yeah. Isn't that a lot bigger flame than we had from the marshmallow?
It's much bigger.
Because there's so many more calories in a peanut than there are in a marshmallow.
Wow, that's cool.
And right now it says 64, 66, 67. So the temperature is still going up. It's continuing to rise, and the peanut is still burning.
Wow, look at that. That's so cool. Huh.
So we've got, that's as high as it's gonna get probably was our 77.
Wow.
So a lot more energy in the peanut. But anyhow, so now maybe you know a little more about calories.
I sure do, Mrs. V.
So I think we're going to go back to Stewart now.
All right, well, we'll see you next time, kids. Thanks for stopping by. Bye-bye.
Back to you, Stewart.
Well, that sure was a neat experiment, huh? Thanks, Maynard and Miss V. Well, the show has almost come to an end, so let's take a look back at Moments to Remember. Well, that's it for today's show. I'm Stewart Farnaby, and remember, my friends, it's better to give than to receive. Bye, everyone. Farewell. Adios. Ciao. Sayonara. Auf Wiedersehen. Shalom. See you next time. Kids Show.
Oh, goody, 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 goody. Wow. Thank you, Stewart. That was so nice.
And on this farm, he had a cow, E-I-E-I-O.
I say the peanut.
I think we're gonna find out that you're right.
Oh, okay, well, let's do it.